thank you all. Since 2014, as part of this hot stove dinner, we have been inducting individuals into the Connecticut American Legion Baseball Hall of Fame. And if you look at the list, it's in your program, and you are familiar with our Connecticut American Legion program, you see that there is a very impressive list of people who have been inducted. Tonight, we're going to add two more people, two more men who have given a great part of their lives to support the American Legion Baseball program. Our first honoree, as you saw up there, from West Haven, manager, coach, state director, zone chairman, was Ed Lettick. And to accept the award on his behalf, it's my pleasure to call on his nephew, Robbie.
My wife and sister and all the umpires over there insist that I should not talk long, so I will not. I promise you that. First off, congratulations to the Berger family for the induction of your brother, as well as all the honorees up here as well. My uncle was passionate about what he did, including American Legion Baseball. And as I look in this program, what stands out, and I like to add to it, is the American Legion Baseball Code of Sportsmanship, and I like to read it, if I may. I will keep the rules, keep faith with my teammates, keep my temper, keep myself fit, keep a stout heart in defeat, keep my pride under in victory, keep a sound soul, a clean mind, and a healthy body. I'd like to add to this, give, not just in baseball, but in anything you do in life, give the best effort you can all the time, and do it with integrity. And that speaks to my uncle, I should say our uncle, very well. I know I sound like a parent, I am, but do the best you can in whatever you pursue and do it with integrity. And I want to thank American Legion for bestowing this honor on my uncle, and the Lettick family is very proud to be here representing my Uncle Ed. And the one big regret, and there's several, that he wasn't here, this is a tough crowd, when the Red Sox won the World Series in 2004. It was a big Sox fan, but thank you very much. Really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Our second inductee is another gentleman who gave a great part of his life to the Rockville American Legion program. Accepting on behalf of Robert Berger is his brother, Don.
Happy to be here to accept this prestigious honor on behalf of my brother. Bob and Helen, his wife, lost a child in childbirth, but he and Helen were blessed to have two beautiful daughters, one of whom is here with us tonight. Oops. I would like to introduce to you Nancy, his daughter. If you'd stand, Nancy, along with your son, Bob's grandson, Ryan. Ryan is a future Legionnaire. He leaves within the next few days or so to join the U.S. Navy, and we wish him well. Bob, my brother, was not a high school athlete, but somewhere along the line, he developed an intense interest in sports, and sports as related to the post 14, the American Legion. Year after year, he put together teams to play in the fast pitch, and when that went down the road, he always had a slow pitch team, and he had a basketball representation as well. And we had a number of the coaches. Matter of fact, they're sitting at this table over here, and I'd like them to stand and just be recognized. But they all played for Verge, and all of them that are here coached at a later point. They have a lot of stories about Bob and conversations that went on forever and whatever. But I'd like to have Scott Smith and Jim Martello, Greg Berger, Art, and Nick Wheelock, if you'd stand. They're former players and coaches. We appreciate coming out to honor Bob. As you can see, I don't see too well, so anyway. Dave covered some of the things, and I don't want to repeat them particularly, but Bob was those of you that knew him, as a matter of fact, Paul tells me you used to have a beer with him at the Bristol Legion. Was it Moosehead? Where'd he go?
What's that? Talking about the beer.
Moosehead?
Moosehead.
Moosehead at the Bristol Legion. I didn't know he drank that, but but he was behind the scenes sort of a guy, and he, back then, Rockville, Post 14, was the only program in the area. In other words, Holland, Summers, Ellington came along later, and a fixture in spring would be my brother going around to the different high schools looking for talent. And that and his other thing that I remember, I don't know whether he had warm blood or whatever, but the coldest day of the year, he'd be there with his binoculars looking over the talent and wearing shorts. Some of you guys that are go back might remember that. But he did all the things that, you know, it's not the most thankful job, as many of you can attest, I'm sure. But there are a lot of satisfactions, and he certainly found satisfaction in doing it for 55 years. I can't imagine. I did it for 8 years, and it was a tough 8 years. He had a kind of a family approach to it, in that he always had soda at the games, and I know from a fact that on more than one occasion, he paid for the insurance out of his own pocket until the finances were available to cover it. And he had certain opinions on things, and one of them was he resented the fact that most clubs were charging their players, and he just, that was not in his plan, and he resisted it for years and years and years, but they raised money with spaghetti dinners and whatnot, and he had some very loyal sponsors that helped out, so he did it. He got it done. His grandchildren lovingly call him Champ. he certainly was that, and he, you know, will, this award will help to all of us to remember him and all that he did for the youth of the Rockville area. Thank you.